Big issue on the ballot tonight, the combat tax in Jackson County.
Here are the results. 71% voted yes, 29% no. KMBC 9's Michael Mahoney is live with what this means to you, Michael.
Larry, it means that the $20 million a year tax to fight drugs on the street and treat its victims will continue past 2011. That's when it was set to expire. Now, those numbers that you just saw on the screen are astounding county officials tonight. They were cautiously optimistic and confident about this vote tonight, but nothing like this landslide that they experienced. And so, quite frankly, they're breathing much easier this evening.
And it looks like it's 68% yes.
It was a good night after all, but boosters of the tax always had it in the back of their minds that it could go wrong.
The reality is, running any type of tax campaign in the teeth of the worst recession we've probably seen in two or three generations, we knew there were going to be significant challenges, and there were.
Many of the voters who renewed the tax say they feel that while not perfect, the combat anti-sales drug tax did fight drugs in the county and did help people get treatment.
It worked for me. I have 9 years clean. I graduated drug court. I'm now successful in my life, clean and sober. So, yes, it does work.
One of the biggest changes coming in the renewed combat anti-drug sales tax strategy, going after drug-related violent crime.
Almost all of our violent crime has a drug nexus, but what this will do will allow us to put investigative resources towards those crimes before we're able to identify that nexus, which will give us the advantage of solving those crimes quicker.
Now, there was limited organized opposition to the combat tax that was on the ballot today that cruised to victory. But one of the people that was an outspoken critic of it, Patrick Toohey, told me on the phone just a little while ago that he understands why people voted to fight the effort of drug crime. But he also says that he hopes that county officials do not take this big victory tonight for granted. And he hopes that they're just as concerned about public money as they are public safety. As combat rolls up a landslide victory and it's renewed for the third time. Back to you.
Hey, Michael, you talked to voters. What did they have to say about this?
Laura, the voters that voted yes for it said that despite some problems, they basically believed that the combat tax worked, that it did fight drugs, although it didn't eradicate it, certainly in the county, and that it helped victims. The people that voted against it were really concerned, many of them, about the timing of this. As we mentioned, this tax doesn't expire until 2011. They were wondering why they were voting on a renewal of it in 2009. Back to you.